market data available to everybody on the level playing field? Yes, but at much different price points. And I think that, you know, and that's something that needs to be examined, because I think that, yes, it's okay to go to a Yankees game and, you know, want to pay more to be at the front. But, you know, in the United States stock markets and the option markets, I think that, you know, there should be equal access, that people should be have access to the same information. I think that simply investing more in the SIPs, you know, and making those more robust, and, you know, and obviously taking a look at the market data costs from the exchanges that have just gone straight up. Okay, when everything else technologically has gone down over time, I mean, I think that there's definitely some smoke there. And I think that equal access is important, because I think that, you know, I think we have the most mature liquid capital markets in the world, you know, but that's about trust and confidence. And when people feel that, if there's a perception, okay, whether it's real, you know, whether it's actually true or not, you know, perception is reality. And if people always feel like they're in the cheap seats and the liquidity providers are, you know, sitting in the first row, that's not a good feeling. And I think that needs to be addressed. And, you know, and I think that, you know, the amount of, you know, cost that's gone into, you know, added onto the system by the exchanges charging for premium market data feeds really needs to be looked at. You know, on the rebate side, I mean, I think that, you know, there's obviously, you know, certain trends out there, whether they should be banned or whether they should, you know, whether they should be allowed. And, you know, I think that, you know, in reality, what we see out there is, you know, especially at the institutional level, you know, customers are very savvy, okay? They know where their trades are going, why they're going there, what the liquidity indicators are. And to kind of go from the prism that the whole world is in an all-in model and we need to ban rebates to prevent a conflict, you know, I would say, number one, I think that, you know, at the institutional level, you know, the customers have the transparency that they need to see if there's a conflict, if there's conflicted routing. And they would just select not to use that person if that was the case. You know, secondly, I think a lot of customers moving towards a cost-plus model, okay, where they can actually benefit from the rebates, where they get charged a commission and then they pay their take fees, you know, and then they collect their rebates. And I think that that makes for, you know, a much nicer environment for the institution, because passive strategies, you know, the people that are using, you know, percentage of volume or you know, implementation shortfall strategies, okay, they can actually benefit from their trading by collecting rebates, okay, and lowering the, because at the institutional level, they're looking at net price, okay? Net price is the, you know, obviously the price of the trade, the exchange fees, and then the commissions. You wrap that all together, and that's the price of the trade for the institution, and that's how they're looking at it. So I think it's about transparency, and it's about offering that cost plus model, okay, so people can benefit from the market structure as it exists today. We don't need to rearrange the board.